Hey everyone, it's Jen at Ink Paper Rubber. Well, I'm finally getting around to having time to get the Hero Arts order all checked in and show it to you. I am really excited, some really fun things in this. Everything except for two sets that I'm going to show you are things that we have not had in the store before, so that is really exciting. That is the good news. The bad news is that some of these items that I'm going to show you at the very beginning are actually not for sale. We do not have any of these left. Of course, we had our pre-order for the Hero Arts from the Vaults products, and some of these are things that people have pre-ordered, and I either didn't get extras or any extras that I had ordered have already sold out. But I did want you to go ahead and see them. Sometimes it's easier, even though you're not seeing them in person, rather than just looking in the catalog. It can be nice to see them. These are all things that can be ordered. I do have the catalog here that has all of these items in it, so you can come by and take a look at it in the catalog. And definitely, I would say if there's any of these from the Vault products that you really want to get them on order sooner rather than later. I don't have any idea how long these are going to be around. These are all stamp designs that came from Hero Arts Past. They are celebrating their 45th anniversary, so they've been around since the 1970s. And these are all images that they had retired, but they have brought back some of them. And that is what I am going to show you. I haven't heard anything. I don't know if these are going to be retiring again, if they're going to be around for a while. If there's something you want, your safest bet is to go ahead and get it ordered. So let's go ahead and show you some of these things here. This first one is really fun. It is one of their bold print background stamps, and this one is called All Stamps, and you can see that it just has all different images from their past, so it just kind of makes a really fun, whimsical background. They have a number of them that they have released in wood stamps. Of course, the originals were probably in wood stamps. And these are really nice. You can see that the index on here is printed in gold. And of course, these are really nice wood mounted red rubber. That one is the Baron Kitty. I like this one, the Serene Sun. This one is called Real Poppy. This is probably a little bit more recent than some of them. They had their Shadow Flowers and had a number that were really nice, and that is one of those. This one is really cute. It is called the Carousel Filly. They also took some of their stamps that were originally just in wood, and they have reformatted them and combined them into sets and made clear sets with them, which is really fun. Another thing I want to point out is you notice they have their From the Vault ones have the special banner on it. It has their 45th anniversary logo and then the special gold banner, so it's you can tell them from their regular stamps. This one is called Celestial. This is a really nice one. I did have extras of this, but by the time they got here, they had all been spoken for, and you can just see the various celestial images, the sun and the moon. There's the planets, and then some nice sentiments with it. And here is another one that is from the Vault that they have made into a clear set. And this one is called Travel, and you can see all these fun different travel images. And they have made a die set that goes with that one. So some of their clear sets that they've made from the Vault, they have also made die sets to go with them. Another one is this one here is called Cute Animals. This is another one that is from the Vault. You can see we have these cute little animals. These would be great for baby cards. And there is also a die set for that. And then they also have one that is called Realistic Animals. And you can see here just all different kinds. We've got horses and giraffes. Up there we have a frog and a few sentiments. And likewise, there is a die set for that. One thing I will point out, if you do come in and take a look at the catalog, as I mentioned, it has all these sets in it. And they also have samples for each of them, so that is nice. You can actually see some samples that they've done. All right, now I'm going to get into some things that these are all available for purchase, and I do have a couple of other from the Vaults. The first one that I want to show you, I really like this set a lot. It is called Beach and Sea. It's perfect timing. There's so many fun beachy things out there right now. And so here you can see we have a little mermaid, we have some sea creatures, we have the lighthouse, There's the beach, the flip-flops, and the beach ball and beach pail, and also a couple of sentiments on there. And there is also a die set for that one. And as I mentioned, there are some samples here in the catalog. Yes, probably can get a catalog. I don't have any extra catalogs right now, but I can probably get some and we can mail it. So just give me a call and we'll see if we can get that worked out. So here are some samples with the beach and sea set. Here is another one that is from the vault. If you have kind of a sassy friend, that might be the perfect thing to add to a card that you send to that friend. All right, now we are going to move on to things that are not from the vault. They are just part of the standard Hero Arts line. The first ones I'm going to show you are ones that we've had before. This is their popular color layering sea and sky, and this is a combo set. So you can see you've got the color layering clouds here, and then you have some other beachy things, the palm trees, the beach chair, we have a mermaid, so some fun things. And this one actually is a combo set, so it comes with the dies included with it. And then there is also another color layering set, and this is the color layering waves. So you see there are the waves that you can layer together. And then also some sentiments with that. And that set does not have a die set. Yep, that one is funny. All right, next we have some kind of, I guess, celestial and kind of related things. This is a really nice set that's called Dreams Are Made. And this primarily, this has a lot of really, really good sentiments on it, some quotations. There we have from Shakespeare, to sleep perchance to dream. But we also have some other images. We have some clouds. There we have a really cool looking moon. Love that owl. That's kind of neat. We have some more clouds there. There we have a sun. I love those stars, that kind of galaxy stamp there. So that is a really fun one. Here is another nice one. It is called Lucky Star. And you can see we have the little boy and girl. Here they're looking up, and here they're holding hands and looking up. We also have a dog and a cat. And then we have different constellations here that you can make your own starry sky, like that heart constellation. And then we have some sentiments on here as well. And there is a die set that goes with that one. And if you're doing kind of a starry night sky, this would be a really great stencil to have. This one is really fun. It is called Dreamy Nights, and I do have some samples of this that I will show you pretty soon. So anyhow, those are the ones that are kind of have a celestial theme. And these last ones I am excited about. This is from one of their recent monthly releases, and it was kind of a European release. And I am actually planning to do a European watercolor class in July. I don't know the date yet, but sometime in July, and going to be using these. So this first one is called Venetian Neighborhood, and you can see here we just have all of these windows like they're in the side of a building. There we have a balcony, there's a kitty cat sleeping, we've got some plants on the window, we have somebody has hung their laundry out, and so that one is really fun. I think that will be fun to watercolor. And this is really cool. This is a die that coordinates with it, and you might wonder exactly how that works when you see it. This one is called Peekaboo Doors, and if you look really closely, you can see these openings do not cut all the way around. They only cut part the way of the way around, so they basically create a little hinge, and they do line up with the doors and the windows on here so that you can stamp this and die cut, and you can have all these windows open up so you can have something else inside. How fun would that be to make a card with all those hidden surprises behind those windows? Next up is another color layering stamp set, and this one is the Village color layering. And so you can see there you have the background of the village, and there you have the actual outline of the village itself, and it definitely has kind of a old European feel to it. We also have, there is a tree, so we have some bushes, and then also some sentiments that looks like maybe kind of a cobblestone path. So that one is really fun. And this last one is a standalone die called European Village. And you can see you have these two die cuts that are the faces of buildings, and they definitely have kind of like an old English feel to them. And then you have this die down here that I think would be perfect to make a cobblestone street for your village. So let me show you some samples of some of this to give you a better idea of how you might use them. Here is a sample of the lucky star. You can see the boy and girl looking up at the constellation. And here's another one that they have just used, the little dog looking up and the sentiment, "You're my lucky star." Here is one that, believe it or not, is from The Dreams Are Made, and I love this. These have actually used what I believe are supposed to be the clouds on the stamp set, and instead kind of made them, it looks like mountains kind of floating up in the clouds. I just think that one is absolutely gorgeous. I'm hoping to get a chance to maybe try that one out. There is the Dreamy Nights stencil background. You can see how fun that one is. Here is the Venetian neighborhood, and I like this one a lot. This is using the spotlight technique where you can see that it's just the white on the black in the background, but then they have done a spotlight on that image in the center of it and colored that in. So that's a really fun way to use that stamp. Here is a sample you can see, and I think you can kind of see where they have used the peekaboo doors and all those windows open up. So that is really fun. And then there you can see is a sample of the color layering village. Love that, love that. And we're going to try and do something like that in our European watercolor class. And last but not least, there is the European village die. And you can see they've added a kind of a watercolor background and extended the path going up into the hills there. And here is a completely different take on that. They've added a bridge and a gondolier die cut and use the cobblestones to make waves. So that looks like maybe it's a canal in Venice. So lots of fun stuff here. I hope if you have a chance, you will stop by and check it all out. As I mentioned, if there's anything that you want from their vault collection that we don't have, be sure and let us know so we can get it ordered in for you. Hope you all have a great evening, and we look forward to seeing you soon. Goodbye.